swear by Almighty God.
Swear by Almighty God.
That the evidence I shall give before this committee.
That the evidence I shall give before this committee.
Touching the matter in issue.
Touching the matter in issue.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Thank you very much. You're welcome, Honorable Nominee. On behalf of the members of this committee, I'd like to congratulate you on your nomination by His Excellency the President to the position of Deputy Minister Designate, Ministry of Water Resources, Works and Housing. We'll take you through the process. Honorable Haruna Idrisu will set the ball rolling with regard to your CV, Article 94 of the Constitution. Thank you.
Chairman, thank you very much. With your indulgence, since the Honorable Member is one of our colleagues, a Member of Parliament, we may excuse him from the requirement of 94. Honorable Ahi, congratulations. Can we go to page 3? Page 3 of your CV. 2010 to date, you are a student at Jimpa Law School. Is that the case?
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
And can we just qualify January 2013 to date or going into the future? In recognizing you as Member of Parliament for the new body constituency.
Exactly so, Mr. Chairman.
Chairman, may I take him to page 4 of the CV? I've just been looking at our standing orders, and as our respected whip, we have Committee on Mines and Energy, Committee of Selection, and Appointments Committee, and Committee on Gender and Children. Do we have your permission to accordingly correct current parliamentary committees to reflect what is in our standing orders?
Yes, you can do that.
Yes, Honorable Okudjetua-Blackwa.
Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and let me add my voice also to a voice of congratulations for the Honorable Sampson Ahi. There are quite a number of concerns I have, Mr. Chairman. In terms of the dates, page 3, I noticed that Honorable Sampson Ahi should be writing 2013 where he writes 2012. For example, 2005 to 2012, Joaboso Constituency Member of Parliament. Your tenure expired midnight of January 6, 2013. So if we have your permission to correct that to 2013. I noticed there are a number of that positions held on page 4. Chairman, Gender and Children Committee, 2009 to 2012. That should also be 2013. And then the next one, Vice Chairman, Gender and Children Committee, 2006 to 2008. That should also be 2009, since you were in Parliament till 6 January 2009. Then Parliamentary Committee served. You don't also give us the period. We don't want to believe that you served on all these 7 committees in one Parliament at the same time. What do you have to say about that?
Mr. Chairman, I think I provided the dates.
The dates are provided. Oh, okay. Then I guess I'm using the provisional CV you submitted. Then, Mr. Chairman, I also noticed that between 1997 to 1998, the nominee said he was manager. God is Truthful Susu Group in Seshibodu. I take interest in this. I just want to know how he became manager, what was the scale of the SUSU group, and how was the membership like, Mr. Chairman? Well, Mr. Chairman, if you want me to complete the cycle before he... Okay.
Mr. Chairman, the period stated I was doing my national service in Bodi Anglican Junior High School. So I organized 3 days shopkeepers in Bodi. And so every evening I'll go around and collect some monies and then keep them. So at the end of the month, I give it back and I take 1 day as my commission. And so I did this for that period.
Did you pay tax on it?
Mr. Chairman, no. Mr. Chairman, I didn't pay tax on it because under the laws, I was not supposed to pay tax.
Yeah, then Mr. Chairman, there's another interesting observation I make on his interests. It says football and boxing. First of all, I want to know whether he's a participant, active participant, or he just likes to enjoy these interests from the wings.
Mr. Chairman, I'm not a participant, but I enjoy watching boxing and football.
Well, Mr. Chairman, my follow-up to that is that is that would be quite strange because on 26 July 2007, in this house, he seemed to have been an active participant in one of his hobbies. Is he sure he doesn't participate?
Yeah, you may choose not to answer that question.
Well, Mr. Chairman, that was on a lighter note. My last issue, Mr. Chairman, I noticed that the nominee has considerable experience in working in the cocoa sector, very rich experience, being the district manager of Amajaro Ghana Limited, 2001 to 2003, and then 2003 to 2004, he was a sector manager for the Western and northern regions, or is it western north? Northern part of the western region. Mr. Chairman, Amajaro Ghana Limited was in the news in recent times that there was some concerns about their operations. I just want to know from the nominee if he has any comments to make about this company that he worked with. Well, that will be it, Mr. Chairman.
Well, I don't know. You are looking at his CV. We are not asking substantive questions, so I don't think it's a proper question for him.
Well, I just thought that the nominee could take the opportunity to assure us that at the time he was with Amajaro, everything they did was clean.
I go back to God is truthful, Susu Group. You were dealing with largely rural people. Is that the name of the Susu Group, or you have translated it from the local language into English?
Mr. Chairman, that was the name I gave to the group.
In English?
Yes.
Yes, Honorable Baba Jama.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I think that whilst we are congratulating our brother, his CV seems to be oversimplified. I mean, when you look at the CV, it has about 5 pages, but if we are going to look at the content and put it together, it may occupy maybe only 1 or 2 pages.
And so maybe, and look at, come to page four. The positions held. Is there position held in parliament? When you look at position held in parliament, stroke committee, parliamentary committee served, current parliamentary committee, these are all parliament related positions. So instead of dividing them into three, we could have just put them under one caption and we get every, because these are all positions held in parliament. So I think maybe if he can reorganize that aspect of his CV. Now, when we come to referees, one of the referees that he has provided is the headmaster of Bodi Anglican High School. I was wondering when he was in that school, was that man the same headmaster today? Otherwise,
I think the nominee would do well to provide the name of the headmaster. Because at any point in time, I don't think you are referring to any headmaster who has been the head of that school.
That school.
But you are referring to a specific headmaster.
Mr. Chairman, I thought that the school as an institution, I didn't want to refer to a specific person, but I believe I have a file in the school. So if anybody wants information about me, whoever is the headmaster at the moment can do so. That's why I stated like that.
Well, it sounds reasonable. Okay.
Yeah, but Mr. Chairman, I think that when we're talking about character, talking about refereeing, it's not always only things that you found on the files. There may be certain things that people want to know about you, that people who know you, that's why sometimes they want to even say that somebody you have known for more than 2 years or 3 years, because it is person specific. So maybe if he would be able to provide us with somebody who has known him all this, because over the years, Ahi has changed. And we cannot be sure whether the same Ahi who was at that junior secondary is the same Ahi sitting here. So we have to get a specific person who can tell us something about him as Ahi. I think that if he can provide us with such a name, it will help us.
I don't think that should be a problem for him. Honorable member, please let us have the name. That should be it. Yes, Honorable Alhassan, Dr.
Thank you very much. On page four, positions held in parliament, 2006-2008, vice chairman, gender and children. I thought that we were in the minority then, and therefore may have been deputy ranking or something. So maybe before the vice chairman then begins to quarrel with you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, he's right.
Eric Opoku.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, the first one is on the name of the nominee, Ahi Sampson. I know apart from this name, the people of Bodi call him Ahi Nkrande. Ahi Nkrande. That is Ahi the Machet, which means that Ahi is as powerful as the Machet. But he did not indicate that he has a special name there. You will need to explain that one.
No, then, but is it a nickname or a name properly so called?
No, he should answer it.
Mr. Chairman, among the accounts, if somebody is called Mensa, they refer to him as Brampa. And if my name, Ahi, goes with Nkrande.
Nkrande. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, then when Honorable Okujato posed a question on the interest, his hobbies here, he said he likes watching football. But I think that Honorable Ahi is a footballer himself. He was a goalkeeper.
Really?
He was a goalkeeper. So I'm surprised why he has decided to hide that aspect from us, and he's telling us that he's just enjoying the watching of football. Meanwhile, he's a goalkeeper. He has been a goalkeeper for a long time.
And the people of Bodi are aware.
Honorable member, I believe that he could have been a goalkeeper all right. But now he's talking about his habits now that he likes watching.
No, but the point is
he must have played some time back. But now, amongst his hobbies,
his CV should have indicated that he has been a goalkeeper before. Because I know he's a goalkeeper. Mr. Chairman, I want him to explain why he's hiding that from us. Because I remember between 2006 and 2008, when we were in Parliament, and then we had problems with goalkeeping, with the blasters and all these issues. There was a time he indicated that he's a goalkeeper, and if it we have difficulty getting goalkeepers, he can avail himself of it. So I'm surprised.
No. Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman.
Please explain.
Mr. Chairman, I don't remember saying that, actually.
Mr. Chairman, in fact, it is important for him to open that aspect because someday we may go as Parliament to go and play friendly with a group and we need a goalkeeper and he will be available, so you just explain.
He's told us that he never said any such thing, so let's move on. Any more on the CV?
Mr. Chairman,
yes.
Is he a goalkeeper? That's my question.
No, Mr. Chairman.
Any more on the CV? Yes, Honorable Afeda Gusi.
Yes, you are a member of the ECOWAS Parliament. I want to know whether in ECOWAS Parliament you serve on any committee, because it's not indicated here.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, I serve on the Housing Committee.
So you do well to incorporate it.
Yes.
Right.
Mr. Chairman, a follow-up on that, just to find out from the nominee if he would continue to serve on the ECOWAS Parliament if this committee gives him the nod.
Mr. Chairman, no. When I am the moment I'm keeping it, if I get a nod, then I cease to be a member.
Yes, can we now move to the next area? Yes. Honorable Kujito Ablakwa.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Well, Mr. Chairman, I would like to ask a question on the water sector and then a second question on maintenance. The nominee is going to assist the Minister of Water Resources, Works and Housing. There is currently what is largely considered to be a water rationing program. And it's clear that demand has far outreached supply. I would want to know from the nominee his understanding of the current challenges in the water sector and how he hopes to assist the minister to pursue the president's vision of providing adequate water for the good people of Ghana. My second question has to do with the lack of a maintenance culture, which we all talk about, and that rests its ugly head, especially in the area of bungalows to public servants. We hear of 4 year, sometimes 8 year renovations, which come at huge cost and at huge loss to the taxpayer. Whereas if these bungalows that public officers live in were properly maintained, we could have saved these money so that we don't need to be, you know, every 4 year or every 8 years giving out these huge renovation contracts. What new ideas would a nominee bring to the ministry to improve the maintenance culture in this country? Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, as stated by the honorable member, we are in water crisis at the moment. And it's because of the fact that at the moment in the urban centers, total demand of water is 1.2 million cubic meters. Now we have a facility.
Per which period?
The report.
Per day.
Per day. on a daily basis. We have a facility that can that has capacity to produce 1.1 million cubic meters daily. That facility, we are unable to maximize the production of water. We are only able to produce 690,000 meters, cubic meters daily. So we realize that from the demand, national demand, and the capacity of the facility we have, there is a gap. And then between the capacity and what we're able to produce on a daily basis, there is a gap. Mr. Chairman, there are a lot of reasons why we have this gap. Most of the equipment we are using at the moment are very old. And therefore, if you want to stretch it, you will end up collapsing them. Two, there are not enough production channels equipment. And then also the problem with power. And so these are some of the problems at the urban center. Now when you go to the rural communities, it's handled by Community Water and Sanitation Agency. Last year, His Excellency the President, John Dramani Mahama, launched a program to ensure that we drill 20,000 boreholes within 10 years frame. Last year, the ministry drilled 1,115. This year, the president has charged my minister, Honorable Colonel Zelda, to ensure that by the end of 31st December, we'll have drilled 1,700 boreholes across the country. The whole idea in the rural community is to cover 100%. At the moment, they have covered 63.3%. So these activities being a road are to ensure that we cover the 100%. So these are some of the issues in the water sector, Mr. Chairman. And the second issue, yeah, it is true. This is an issue with that we have as a country. We don't have that spirit of maintenance culture. And so the tendency that we allow government property to decay before we look for resources to, rehabilitate them or renovate them. And so this is an important area. I won't give you a lot. I will strongly recommend to my minister so that we find a solution to this problem.
Yes, Honorable Afedagwisi.
Yes, Honorable Nominee. If you go into the various communities, you see burst pipes with treated water gushing out. Most of the time, people go and report to staff or workers of the corporation. But it takes days before they come and effect the repairs. Now, I want to know from you, when you get a nod, what you do so that workers of water and sewage can take prompt action in repairing those things. Number two, the security services, particularly police, are in dire need of accommodation. In fact, if you go to the urban areas, particularly across Central, if you go there and you see the condition under our police are living, is not anything very good. I want to know from you that when you get the note, what advice, what immediate action will you take by putting into the system this our men who suffer in the night, protect us, but they go home, they don't have any decent place to live. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, on the first issue, we we have the loss control unit in the Ghana Water Company, and they are supposed to respond promptly on such problems. But the briefing I had suggested to me that they lack logistics and personnel. And so, with your approval, I would recommend to my minister for us to look at this problem so that the loss control unit will be well resourced or equip them so that they can be able to respond quickly to such situations. And then the accommodation for the police. I think all of us as a country agree that we have to properly accommodate our security services, which the police is also one. Mr. Chairman, I think that we have to fall on PPP to, as a matter of urgency, find a solution to this accommodation problem for our security services, particularly the police personnel. Thank you.
All right, Honorable Dr. Lassa.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. My question is on customer care and to a large, and also reaction time to problems that confront consumers of products of our water agencies, so to speak. You will find the Community Water and Sanitation Agency that's supposed to do rural water situation. It's true that they train people within community to look at some of these facilities, but sometimes the problems get way above their capacity, and it takes almost forever to get the agency to intervene appropriately. I wanted to find out from you whether this would be identified as a problem between you and your substantive minister so that it can cut down on reaction time to the rural community problems. The second one is about customer care. You find situations where an individual is being billed for consuming water as at the domestic rate. And then the next time his bill or her bill comes, it is jacked up to commercial rates. Without any interaction with the individual, perhaps they may have seen a fufu bar established by his house, and then the assumption is that he owns it and therefore he should not pay commercial rates. Can your minister and yourself take time to ensure that customer care is really institutionalized and seem to be active so that people are not paying for services that they do not really get? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, it is true. When you go to most of the rural communities, you will find out that a lot of boreholes have broken down. And it is also true that sometimes it takes some time before they are repaired. And so it's an issue that I think we will take on board and then look at it critically. Mr. Chairman, on the customer care, we sometimes take the customers for granted. And why should we be charging a domestic consumer commercial rate instead of domestic rates? And I think this is an issue we should we'll look at it critically with the support of the, your approval. And then I'll take it up seriously with my minister so that we'll look at it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Honorable Harun Edrisu.
Chairman, thank you very much. Let me, with Chairman indulgence, congratulate our very young colleague, Sampson Ahi, for catching the president's attention to serve in the capacity as deputy minister. Mr. Chairman, one of the things I note Ahi for is heckling. Yet when he said his interests conspicuously lost was his mastering of the art of heckling on the floor of Parliament. Mr. Chairman, I have just one question. You also can trust him that in any debate on the floor of Parliament, Sampson is likely to end up shouting or whispering Sefi or Akuntumbra or Asenkregua in order that the people of Western Region will be well and truly served. So congratulations. My question is just one major concern to the Ghanaian people or the Ghanaian public. Rent payment. Because of the major problem of housing deficit, poor, middle income, less privileged people are compelled to pay rent. Sometimes they are asked to pay 2 years in advance, 3 years in advance. Some even say 5 years. And some even demand foreign currency, maybe in US dollars. Will our honorable colleague support his minister to back a legislation to deal with this problem? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I think that the issue raised is a very important issue. What is happening now contradicts the Rent Act, because the Rent Act says that we should not pay more than 6 months, but people are collecting 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. And I believe it's as a result of the fact that demand exceeds supply, as you rightly said, that we have deficits in the housing sector. That does not mean that we should violate what the Act says. I think there is something in the pipeline to actually amend the Rent Act as it stands at the moment. And some of these concerns will be taken on board. And very soon, I believe, my minister will present it to Parliament for attention. And then all of us can fashion an act which can suit the modern trend for us.
Thank you. Honorable Baba Jamal.
Mr. Chairman, thank you very much. My brother, Mr. Chairman, mine is not a question, but to extract an assurance from my brother. When Aruna was speaking, he said something that he's noted for heckling and always mentioning Sehi Mbodi. And he has exhibited that even here, anytime any nominee comes, he will always want to ask a specific question: what are you doing for Sehi? What are you doing for Bodi? He always wants Bodi to be remembered. I congratulate him for projecting Bodi, but you are now going to occupy a national office. I want you to give assurance to the whole nation that it's not now going to be Bodi Sehi, but it's going to be Ghana. And everything will be, because you are going to a very key ministry where the distribution of water, rent, houses, all those things are going to be under you. Can you assure us that you will be nationalistic and not surrealistic? This is what I want.
Mr. Chairman, I think my honorable nominee should not entertain any fear. If approved, I'm going to be a deputy minister for the nation, not for Sehi. And so I will be guided accordingly. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Honorable, and then after that, Eric Opoku.
Thank you very much. Mr. Chairman, I want to find out from the nominee that this terrible problem we have of illegal water connection in particular, and recently a TV station captured some of the actors in this particular domain. Some people complained that because of the activities of the water or tank operators, other consumers don't get their share. Is he aware of this problem, and what will he want to do with his minister to bring order to that part of the problem?
Mr. Chairman, I'm not aware of this problem, but I believe illegal connections of water is wrong. And I also know there is the laws control unit in the ministry to actually take care of some of these issues. And my briefing, I was told that there is a draft law in place which will be brought to Parliament so that those corporates can be sanctioned. So once the Honorable Member has raised it, we'll seriously look at it and then look at how we can actually reduce it, if not eradicate it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Honorable Eric Opoku.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, let me also congratulate the honorable nominee for his nomination to this big office. I know him very well. He's a hardworking colleague, and I know Ahi will deliver on the mandate bestowed on him. I have two simple questions for him. The first one has to do with the issue he raised with respect to PPP when he was responding to a question posed by the Honorable Member for Ashaman with respect to police accommodation, security accommodation. He mentioned PPP. In the water sector, they have two different forms of PPP. They have the public-private partnership, and they have another triple piece in the pricing of water, which is polluter pays principle. I'd like to find out from the honorable nominee whether he understands polluter pays principle, and then how this principle is applicable in terms of water pricing in this country. That is number one, so you take note. Then, number two, you also talked about housing deficit when you were responding to the same question. And I remember very well that we started working on some affordable housing units in this country. During the time of President Kufuor. And these projects are all over the country now. The impression is being created that because this project was started by the MPP government, the NDC government does not want to continue the project. That's the impression out there. I want you to tell the committee the current state of this project and what can be done to complete these projects. That is the number two. Then the last one, which is very, very simple. I think I said two, but I've made it three, because I think that you'll be able to answer all the questions. The last one has to do with the water crisis. You enumerated the numerous challenges that culminated in the crisis we are experiencing today. But you did not tell us how we can evolve measures to surmount the challenges. And I think it's important as leaders, we try to find solutions to problems rather than expatiating on the problems alone. So you look at it and see what we can do to remedy the situation. And Mr. Chairman, I must say that I congratulate him very well. He has been a very close friend.
It's all right, Honorable Member. We've had enough of that. Honorable nominee, answer the questions.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, the polluter pays principles says that he who pollutes the water must be made to pay for the cost of treating it. This is because if you pollute the water, it has to be treated before distributed to consumers. And it will not be fair to pass on the cost of treating it to consumers. So if you pollute the water, the cost of treating it, you are made to pay for it. I think that is the whole idea about the polluter pays principle. On the issue of the housing deficits and the affordable housing, I don't agree to the assertion that because MPP started it, that is why NDC government don't want to pursue it. Mr. Chairman, when completed, these facilities becomes property of the state. But what actually happened was that, for me, I think enough funds was not sought for before embarking on the project. They started with some funds from HIPIC, and then when it got exhausted, they moved to SNIT for a loan. Some work has been done. The rest of the work requires 241 million Ghana cedis before we can complete these houses. And so when given a nod, I think because it will be the property of the country, we have to work so that we will complete it. And I will recommend strongly to my minister so that we fund the necessary resources to continue and then complete it. On the with regards to how we solve the water problems, I stated that we have old age equipment, and so what I think we should do is to rehabilitate some of them or procure new ones to lay them so that they can stand the national requirements. Also, we have to construct new distribution channels so that many more consumers can have access to drinkable water. So some of these solutions will be looked at, and then we'll pursue them to see whether we can actually solve the water crisis problem. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you very much. Honorable members, this brings us to the end of the session for Honorable Sampson Ahi. But before we discharge him, we will want to acknowledge the presence of a few people here. Nana Adria Payne, Queen Mother of Safi, you also traditional area is here with us. We also have Nana Ekwensia, Queen Mother of Sefi Bode. We have Madam Grace Andor, the mother of the nominee. And we have Madam Grace Andor again, nominee's mother's sister. We also have Nana Yao Ntadu the Third, Kontinyini of Sefi, also traditional area. Nana Kwesi Bukuri the Second, Achempemhene of Sefi, also. Nana Ataya of the Second, Nifahini of Sefi, also traditional area. Nana Tewusu, representative of Bodihene. And Archdeacon Bismarck Aka Kento, Anglican Church of Bodi. Mr. John Ampim. Mr. Johnson Ama. Nana Tuku, Western Regional Chairman of NDC. Mr. Joseph Kobuna, Western Regional Secretary, Madam Anita A.C. Annan, Western Regional Women Organizer, Mr. Kenneth Asante, Bodi Constituency Chairman, Alhaji Said Ben Isha, Bodi Constituency Secretary, Mr. Opoku Shadrach, Bodi Constituency Organizer, Nana Hamidu Kramu, Bia East Constituency Chairman, Honorable members of the Western Regional Caucus are here with us. Yeah. This is for Bodi, Jabeso, Akontombra, and we also are also here with us. We also have Nana Kwao Bwedu II, Chief of Ataboka. We have the Honorable Evans Edu Brahafu Regional Minister here with us. Deputy Regional Minister Designate for Western Region. He's been sworn in. Okay. Abbott is also here with us. And Nana Ajiman the First. Benkumhene is also here with us. Thank you. Honorable Ahi, questions are being asked about your better half. Is she here?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Why?
It's traveled.
Okay. Honorable member, thank you for attending upon this committee. You are discharged.